students, hope you all are fine and safe. Today we are going to start exercise 6C and 6D of the chapter HCF and LCM. Moving on ahead, the first topic is LCM. The full form of LCM is lowest common multiple or least common multiple. From the name itself, we are able to determine what does LCM means. LCM is also known as the smallest common multiple. Suppose two given numbers are there and we are supposed to find out the LCM of those numbers. Then first of all, we will be finding out the multiples of the given numbers and then the common multiples of those numbers. After finding out the common multiples, out of those common multiples, the smallest common multiple is referred to as the LCM. It is simply the smallest of all the common multiples. Very easy concept, LCM, lowest common multiple or least common multiple, or you can say the smallest of all the common multiples is known as LCM. Common multiple is a number which is a multiple of two or more numbers. Common multiples, here I have written the definition, but this you have already studied in the previous class. So, common multiple is that number which is a multiple of two or more given numbers. Second point is methods to find LCM. The first method is by inspection method. Second, by prime factorization method, and number three is by division method. These are the three given methods by which we are able to find out the LCM of given numbers. Now we'll study in detail about these methods and we'll try to find out the LCM of these numbers or of the given numbers by the given methods. The first method is by inspection method. Step 1. Start with the table of the biggest number. Begin checking with its first multiple. I am repeating it again. Start with the help of the biggest number table. Out of the given numbers, suppose you are given two numbers, the number which is the bigger number, you are supposed to start with the table of that bigger number and then we will start checking its first multiple. If the multiple occurs in the tables of the other numbers, it is the LCM. The second number which is there, if the multiple of the bigger number occurs in the table of the another number, then that number is the LCM. If not, check the next multiple of the biggest number. Suppose you are given two numbers, 4 and 8. So 8 is the bigger number. Now I'll try finding out the multiples of 8. So the multiples of 8 are 8, 12, 16, then similarly 24. But now I'll check the first multiple of 8 is 8. Now moving on to the another number, that is 4. The multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12. Now here the smallest common multiple is 8 because 8 is the multiple of 8 also and 4 also. So 8 will be the least common multiple, that is LCM. Now let us take a look over some of the illustrations. The first question is 10 and 15. First of all, we will be finding out the multiples of 10 and 15. The multiples of 10 are 10, 20, 30, 40, so on. Multiples of 15 are 15, 30, 45, 60 and so on. Now we will find out the smallest multiple, smallest common multiple. So here you can see the brown colored number. The brown colored number, which one is the brown colored number? 30. So 30 is the smallest common multiple. So the LCM will be 3030. Before 30, no other multiple is common. So 30 is the least common multiple. Now second question, 9 and 12. First of all, we'll be finding out the multiples of 9. 9, 18, 27, 36, 45 and so on. Then finding out the multiples of 12, 12, 24, 36, 48 and so on. Now here you can find out the common multiple. The smallest common multiple of 9 and 12 is 36. So the LCM will be 36. Moving on ahead. Question number 3. 6, 10 and 15. The multiples of 6 are 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36 and so on. The multiples of 10 are 10, 20, 30, 40, so on. The multiples of 15 are 15, 30, 45, 60 and so on. Now here you can see the purple colored numbers. The purple colored number is only 30. Why? Because 30 is the only common multiple. Not only common multiple. 30 is the smallest common multiple here. So the LCM will be 30. The least common multiple or the lowest common multiple will be 30 here. Now question number 4. 3, 4 and 5. Three numbers are given and we are supposed to find out the LCM of the given numbers. So first of all, we will be finding out the multiple of 3. So the multiple of 3 are 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. In this manner, we will be finding out the multiples of 3. Then similarly, the multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, 20 and so on. Similarly, the multiples of 5, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 and so on. Now, here we will find out the common multiple. Out of these, all the multiples, the common multiple is coming out to be 60, and here you can see 60 is the smallest common multiple, because after 60 it may happen that we may get the common multiples, but which will be the smallest common multiple? 60 will remain the smallest common multiple. So the LCM will be 60. Now students, just remember, these questions I have done by inspection method or by multiplication table method. Inspection method and multiplication table methods are both the same. Then another thing, these questions can be done by the rest of the two methods also, by prime factorization method and by division method also. It is up to you whichever method you wanted to adopt. Now the second method is by prime factorization method. This is the second method by which we can find out the LCM of the given numbers. So the step one is write each number as a product of prime factors. You know how to write the given number as a product of prime factors. Then second point, keep each factor the greatest number of times it occurs. this step I am repeating. Keep each factor the greatest number of time it occurs. Then number 3, multiply those factors. These are the steps. Let's take some examples so that you will be able to understand how to find out the LCM by this given method. Now the question number 1 is 36 and 54. So first of all, we are supposed to write down the numbers or the given numbers in the form of the product of the prime factors. In order to find out the prime factors, what we are supposed to do, first of all, we'll find out the prime factors with the help of prime factorization method. Here you can see I have taken out the factors of the given numbers. Moving on to the first number, 36, we'll find out the least prime number by which 36 can be divisible. So the least prime number by which 36 is divisible is 2, and the remaining quotient is 18. Now again, 18 is divisible by the least prime number 2, and the quotient is 9. Now 9 cannot be divisible by 2, so we'll move one step ahead. That means the another prime number after 2, the another prime number is 3, so we'll divide 9 by 3, then we'll get the quotient as 3. Now again, 3 can be divisible by 3 and the quotient will be 1. So we'll follow the same process until and unless we'll get the quotient as 1. Again, the next number is 54. Then 54 is divisible by the least prime number 2 and the quotient will be 27. Then 27 is divisible by the least prime number 3 because it is not divisible by 2, so we will move ahead, and the another prime number is after 2, another prime number is 3, so we will divide 27 by 3. We will get the quotient as 9. Then again 9 will be divisible by 3. And then again 3 will be divisible by 3, and at the end we got 1. Now here we have got all the factors of the given two numbers, and here you can observe all the given factors are only prime numbers. They are prime numbers only. So now we'll write down these factors in the form of product. 36 is written as 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3. And then 54 is written as 2 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3. It is written in the product form. Now, the second point or the second step to find out the LCM by prime factorization method is the factors which is occurring the maximum time that we are supposed to take. So, in 36, 2 is occurring the maximum time, 2 is occurring 2 times. So here you can see the underlined red colored letters. So 2 is occurring 2 times. So we have taken as the factor which is occurring the maximum time. 3 is also occurring 2 times, but in the next number 3 is occurring 3 times. So 2 is less than 3. So in the next one, we'll take 3 times it is occurring. So this will be the maximum number of times 3 is occurring, right? And now the third step was to multiply the maximum number of times the factors are occurring. We are supposed to multiply those factors. So let's multiply. So LCM will be 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3. So the answer will be 108. I am repeating it again. You are supposed to multiply only those factors which are occurring the maximum number of times. Here 2 is occurring 2 times and 3 is occurring 3 times. So 3 will be taken 3 times. Why? Because it is occurring the maximum number of times. That's why. And then multiplying all the factors which are occurring the maximum number of times, we'll get the answer as the least common multiple. Now the second question is 20, 30 and 40. Now here again we'll find out the factors by prime factorization method. Here you can see 20, 30 and 40. We have taken out the prime factors. Now writing those prime factors in the form of product, 20 can be written as 2 into 2 into 5. Then 30 can be written as 2 into 3 into 5. And then 40 can be written as 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 5. Now here the LCM is 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 5. So the LCM is 120. Now in the second step I told you that the factor which is occurring the maximum number of time, we are supposed to highlight those factors. So in 20, the maximum number of time, 2 is occurring 2 times, 5 is occurring 1 time. Now again coming to 30, 2 is occurring 1 time, 3 is occurring 1 time and 5 is occurring 1 time. Then in 40, 2 is occurring 3 times. So which factor we will take? The factor which is occurring 3 times, no? So we'll highlight the factor 2 multiply 2 multiply 2. So here the factor which we have taken, it is occurring 3 times. Now coming on to another factor 5. In 20, 30 and 40, 5 is occurring only 1 time. So either you can take the factor from 20 or 30 or 40. Here I have taken from 20. And similarly, 3 is also occurring 1 time and that is only in 30, in number 30. So we'll highlight 3 also. So now here you can see all the factors which were occurring the maximum number of times, we have highlighted with the red color. So after multiplying all the highlighted factors, we got the LCM 120. The last method is by division method. First step, divide the given numbers by the least prime number. Write the quotient and the number which is not divisible by the above prime number in the second row. Third point, divide the numbers with another least prime number. Continue the division until the remainder is a prime number or 1. Multiply all the divisors and remaining prime numbers, if any, to obtain the LCM. So the first point is, like we are doing the prime factorization method, we are dividing the given number by the least prime number. Same manner we will do. Then second step, if another number is not divisible by that particular prime number, we'll write the as it is, that number as it is in the second row, and we'll try to divide it by another prime number. In this manner, we will follow this division process until we get 1 or any prime number in the last row, and then we'll multiply all the divisors which we are getting, including the prime numbers which are left in the last row. In this manner we can obtain the LCM by division method. Now note, division method is helpful in finding out the LCM of large numbers. This is a very important point. See, division method is very easy and it is helpful in finding out the LCM of large numbers. You cannot find out the LCM of very large numbers through the process of inspection method, because it is very difficult to write down the tables of the large numbers. Similarly, by prime factorization method also you can find out, but there also some chances are there that you may make mistakes. So what I prefer, you can do easily, or you can find out easily the LCM of any number, of the any given two or more numbers, with the help of division methods easily. So try performing the LCM by division method And one more thing, any question can be done by any method. Any question can be done by any of the three given method, but try to do it by division method. The first example is 75, 125 and 150. Now I have written 75, 125 and 150. Now I'll try to divide it with the least prime number. See, 75 cannot be divisible by 2. 125 also, it cannot be divisible by 2. But 150 can be divisible by 2. So we'll divide 150 by 2. So we'll get the quotient as 75. And rest of the two numbers which are not divisible by 2, we'll write them as it is in the second row. Then again, in the second row we got 75, 125, 75. Now, neither of these numbers can be divisible by 2. So we'll move one step forward. We'll come to the prime number 3. Now, 75 can be divisible by the prime number 3. But 125 cannot be divisible. So we'll divide 75 by the prime number 3. And we'll get the quotient as 25. And 125 will be writing as it is in the third row. Now again, in the third row, we got 25, 125, 25. Now all these numbers can be divisible by 5. And 5 is also a prime number. So we'll divide these numbers by 5. So we'll get the quotient as 5, 25 and 5. Then again, 5, 25 and 5 can be divisible by 5. So 5 ones are 5. And 5 5s are 25 and again 5 1s are 5. Now in the second last row the numbers are 1 5 and 1. So again 5 can be divisible by 5 and then we'll get the quotient as 1. So in the last row you can see all the numbers are 1. So this method, we have completed our division method. Now how we will find out the LCM? We will multiply all the factors and the product of all the factors will be the LCM. So LCM will be 2 multiply 3 multiply 5 multiply 5 multiply 5. So the answer will be 750. The second question is 108, 120, 132. Now again, we'll find out 108, 120 and 132 are divisible by the least prime number 2. Then we'll get the quotient as 54, 60, 66. Again, these numbers can be divisible by the least prime number 2. Then the quotients will be 27, 30, 33. Then 27 cannot be divisible by 2. 30 can be divisible and 33 cannot be divisible. So first of all, we'll divide 30 by the least prime number 2 and 27 and 33 will be written as it is in the fourth row. And after dividing 30, we'll get the quotient as 15. Then again, 27, 15 and 33 can be divisible by 3. Then the quotients will be 9, 5 and 11. Then again, 9 can be divisible by 3. Then the quotients will be 3, 5 and 11. 5 and 11 cannot be divisible by 3. So they will be written as it is. Now in the last row you can see the prime numbers 3, 5 and 11. We can leave them as it is. Why? Because these are those prime numbers which are divisible by themselves only. So either you can divide and show the process till 1 or you can leave it as it is. Now the LCM will be, but when we are leaving as it is, the one thing to keep in your mind is you are supposed to multiply all the factors. So here we'll multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3 and again the last row numbers also we are supposed to multiply 3 multiply 5 multiply 11. So our LCM will be 11,880. Hope you must have understood this whole process. Now let's move towards the home assignment. You are supposed to find out the LCM of the following numbers. The first point is 48 and 72, 12 and 15, 21 and 63, 39 and 78, 4, 7 and 9, 8, 9 and 112, 60, 80 and 180, and the last one is 8, 12 and 48. In this question, you are supposed to find out the LCM. The name of any method is not written. So you can find out the LCM by any method, whichever you like. No queries related to the methods should be there. If in the question, the name of method is not mentioned, you can do the question by any method. But try to do it by division method because it is helpful in finding out the LCM of the larger numbers. Thank you for your keen observation. Hope you must have understood all the topics well.